Here's Marama Papau with the state of Pacific education in New Zealand.
We came to this land of plenty, and we came
yes, we came to the land of plenty, and we came to get a better education for our kids. But it's been a massive failure. And this is how we've failed. Despite the huge support for early childhood education, around 15% of our Pacific kids are still not in ECE. At secondary school level, around 1 in 2 Pacific Year 11 students still don't have the most basic secondary school qualification, Level 1 NCEA. And in 2009, 23% of Pacific school leavers did achieve UE, compared to 75% of Bālangi.
The bottom line is that the system is failing.
We need to do something, and doing nothing is not an option.
Successive governments have tried to overhaul the system. The latest example of that is the national standards. So far, it's not made a jot of difference to our people.
We really didn't need them. We had enough information in our school with a huge array of testing that we do to know where our kids are.
And where do you start is another question. The Bilingual Leo Pacific Coalition believes firmly that if your child is bilingual, they will achieve better in education.
Their academic achievement is raised substantially, but the reluctance of government and of the ministry to consider that research is, I suppose, disappointing.
The group presented a petition to Parliament in August requesting official minority status to 5 Pacific languages. And Pasifika parents have always felt strongly about their children's success. Earlier this year, the community also held a whānau about their concerns around Pasifika underachievement.
It's a matter of doing something about it, whether that's through the school, through the Ministry of Education Department, through parliamentary changes of policy and laws. We have to do something.
And we're going to need not just good teachers, but great teachers. Not just some making the transition well between primary and secondary and tertiary, and out to jobs, but we're going to need all Pacific New Zealanders making that transition well.
In the end, though, it also comes down to parents doing their bit.
Too many times parents are too busy, too tired or whatever, and fob off those really critical questions that are important for a child's development.
For some reason, we've lost sight of why we came. For some reason, we've lost sight of our dream. And yet the tree is in our hands. We can do something about it. It's the challenge is bringing everyone together to do our part.